Alright folks, this is going to be a super quick tutorial on the Model Context Protocol. You've heard about it on X, you are a Vibe coder and you're using AI tools like Cursor and Windsurf, but you have no idea how to get started. You look at the docs, but everything is just a little bit unclear. You search on YouTube for tutorials, and some of them are an hour long and involves all kinds of stuff. I've been using Cursor for a long time. I've been using Windsurf for a while, but I found it really difficult to even get started using it. So this tutorial is for you. I created this tutorial just to be a quick and easy way to build a very simple MCP server with one tool. And all this tool does is that it takes in a name and it just responds to that name with a hello world greeting. But once you understand the basic structure of an MCP server and what tooling works, and you know how to build it, and you know how to get Cursor and Windsurf or VS Code to run it, I think you're all set. You can then go off and use some of the other more complicated tools, or you can build your own. All you need to do is actually go onto this GitHub page that I created here, which is the MCP Hello World, which you can see the link here. You can clone it. Just go into your favorite editor, whether it's Cursor or VS Code, or even just the terminal. Create a new directory, say proj, and then go to proj, and then just git clone that, and go into the folder, and you can do a cursor dot, which should pretty much open it up in your favorite IDE. And let's get started building your first MCP server and tool. All right, so once you've opened up your project within VS Code or Cursor or Windsurf or any editor of your choice, you will notice that it's actually fairly simple. It only contains four files, right? The first one is a package.json, which mainly sets up information about your project, which we're just going to call MCP Hello World. But the main thing that it does is that it sets whatever dependencies that we need. And the most important thing that we need here is the Model Context Protocol SDK. And because we're using TypeScript, we have a few other dependencies as well. The TS config, this is pretty standard. You can just copy and paste it. It just specifies how to compile TypeScript into JavaScript. And package log.json is actually generated, but it's usually good practice to put it as part of a repository as well. You can just safely ignore it. And the only other file that you have here is the index file, which is where you're going to define your MCP server. And you can see that all we need is really pretty much five steps. We import the dependencies, we create a server instance, we list the tools that we have, which I'll explain, you handle how you want to call the tool, and then you start the server, and you're pretty much done. All right, so let's get started with building our first tool. So what you want to do is that you go into the source folder, and create a subfolder called tools. Now you don't really have to do this. This is just good practice to organize the tools that you're gonna have. The tool that we will be building for this tutorial is a greeting tool, all right? And all it's gonna do is that it's gonna take in a name and it's gonna greet that name. Once you understand this basic building block and you are able to call it within Cursor, Windsurf, or any other IDE of your choice, you can start building more complicated tools, or you can download and use some of the popular external tools that people have been talking about, such as Puppeteer, web browsing, local file system, connecting to Superbase, but we'll only get to that in a separate tutorial. We want to focus on the basics here. So let's begin implementing our tool. And you're going to implement this in just four steps. The first thing you want to do is that you want to import the dependencies. And the only dependency that you need is from Zot. And I'll explain what this means next. When you're creating a tool, you want to create what you call a schema. And the schema defines what the input and the output is to the tool. And in this case, like I mentioned, the only input that it's going to take is that it's going to take a name, which is a string. And Zot helps us to define several of these types. So it could be a number, it could be a string. In this case, we just say that it just takes in a name that should be a string. And the next thing that we need to do is to do what we call a tool listing information. And this is pretty much just saying what the name is, what the description is, and what the input schema is, which is in this case, like I said, it's just takes in an object. The only properties is that it takes in a name, it's of a type string. And here's some description of this is the name that it's going to greet. And we're just specifying that the name is going to be a required input to the tool. So if you don't specify it, then it's going to be a problem. And finally, we're just going to implement the tool. And this is also very simple. We call it handle greeting, in which case we say the first thing we're going to do is that we're going to validate using the schema that whatever is being passed into the tool is indeed a name that is a string, not a number, not something else. And then once it's been validated, all it's going to do is that it's going to return it in the following format. It's going to return the content and it's going to be of type text. And all it's going to say is hello name, welcome to the Model Context Protocol. The simplest tool that you can imagine. But like I said, once you get this working, you can go on and do more advanced stuff or utilize other people's stuff very easily. Okay, so now that the tool is done, we just need to integrate this with our MCP server. So back to our MCP server, very similar again, all we're going to do is that we're going to import the dependencies first. And you don't really need to go into too much detail here, but a quick summary is that you're going to get a server instance, the transport layer, how you're going to call the tool, how you're going to list the tool, and that's pretty much all you need. So let's create the server instance here. So the server instance is just creating a server with a name and a version, and you can leave the capabilities empty for now because it doesn't really matter. Because in the next portion, we're actually going to specify what the list of tools that this server is going to have. So whenever it receives a call for listing its tools, it's just going to return whatever is listed here. So currently it's empty, so let's import our greetings tool. The way that you do this is that, if you recall, in the greetings tool, we actually had a tool definition as well as how to handle it. And so we're going to import both of these into our server here. So greeting tool definition and handle greeting from the tool. And then all we have to do is that we'll add in that the greeting tool is, and now we're going to put in the definition as one of the tools. So if you create more and more tools, you just add it to this list here, and the MCP server will become aware about it. So we've handled the listing. Now all we need to do is handle how to call the tool. And this is also very straightforward. Whenever there's a request to call the tool, what we're going to do is that we're going to check what the name of the tool is. In this case, we know that it's greeting. And then we call the handle greeting method that we had from before, that we defined before. And if you add more and more tools, you just add more and more handlers here. Like I said, it's just want to keep it simple so that people can get started on using MCP servers. And the last step that we have to do is just start the MCP server. So we're going to create a main method. So like I said, the transport is just using the server transport protocol that we've imported from the SDK. And then we connect the server to the transport protocol, and we just add a log just to prove everything's working. And a nice to have as well is to catch any errors that we might get when we run the server. And that's it. You have created your first MCP server, as well as the first tool that the MCP server is going to use. Now I'm going to show you how to build it and how to integrate it with either Cursor or Windsurf. It should be pretty similar doing this in other IDEs like VS Code with Client, but I think these two are the most popular ones right now. I'm in the server folder now, and all you have to do is do npm run build. And this is going to create a build directory. And you can test this very quickly. You can do node build index.js, and it will say, hello MCP server running on stdio. Perfect, this means it's running. And you can kill this now because we don't need to run it manually. What we're going to do is that we're actually going to do this within Cursor itself. So the way you do this is that you do Command Shift P, right, and do Cursor Settings. And within Cursor Settings, go to Features, scroll down, and MCP Servers, yeah? And this is where you add in your new MCP server. Now, a few things that you need to do that will make your life easier. Just open the terminal and do pwd, which will tell you where your server is, right? And just copy this for a second. And then now you do it at MCP server. Just call it whatever you want. You can call it MCP hello. It doesn't really matter. Make sure this is of type command. And the command that you want to do is you do node space, paste the path that you copied earlier, and then add in the build index.js. And that's pretty much it. And now here you go. If this works, you will see that it's green. It will tell you that there is the greeting tool here, and you're ready to go. So how you use it within Cursor is that you open it up in Command I, you switch it to agent and say, call the greeting tool with my name, Chong-U, which in this case is my name. I'm going to submit it. And what you're going to see is that it does a bit of thinking because I'm using the thinking version of Claude, but then it's going to pull up this window and says, call MCP tool with the name here. I'm going to run the tool, and it's going to say, hello, Chong-U, welcome to the model context protocol. And this is pretty much it. Your MCP server is running, and you've got your first tool working as well. And this is pretty much all you need to know about how to get an MCP server running in Cursor. Now, we're going to do this for Windsurf as well, which is going to be almost exactly the same. So what I'm going to do is switch over to Windsurf now. So you can be in any project that you want. It doesn't really matter. What you're going to do is open Cascade, all right? And you're going to see here MCP, zero available MCP servers. And all you need to do here is you click on this and do configure. And this is where Windsurf really shines, right? It shows you exactly how to configure it. There's no user interface, but at least it gives you an example of how you want to configure it. So all you need to do here is just copy and paste this and into the config file that has emerged. Save it, and we're going to change a few things, right? So our thing is called MCP hello world. Great. We're going to use the node command. If you switch back to Cursor here, you can see I use node. And then I'm going to copy the same arguments to it. It's going to be the node command, and the arguments that I'm going to need is simply the same thing. And you can delete the other stuff that's not required. So this is pretty much the same as what in Cursor, right? It's just that Cursor has a nice user interface. Windsurf requires you to actually do it manually. So you save it, and then you go back here. On the right, you do refresh, and there you go. You can actually see your MCP server showing up. This is a tool from the MCP Hello World. MCP server returns a greeting message. And the way you use it is very simple. It's call the greeting tool from MCP Hello World with my name. And there you go. What it's going to do is going to think, because I'm using Claude Solid Thinking as well. It knows to use the MCP server, and then It says, the MCP server has greeted you with the message, hello Chong-U, welcome to the model context protocol. And there you have it. You built your MCP server, you built your first tool, and now you know how to run it within Cursor, as well as Windsurf, and you're all set. So if you need to use any other tool, you can download it and effectively run it and integrate it the same way. And if you need to build your own tools, you know how to do so as well. There's been so many tutorials out there that makes it so difficult and so complicated to get started. So if you found this very helpful, don't forget to give this video a like. I do a lot of other AI stuff on my channel, so do check it out, especially if you're interested in AI and game development. And I hope you continue building more and more great MCP stuff. See you next time.